learn about physical examination. So physical examination can be defined as the complete health assessment of the patient or of a person, which is done from head to toe. So now we will move to the indication. So physical examination is done while admission of the patient and before and after of any diagnostic procedure, during discharge or during any follow-up period. So purposes of physical examination. So physical examination help us to obtain the baseline data during the admission of any patient, and then it help us to drive nursing diagnosis for their better treatment, and to check any deviation from its normal reading, and also to see the progress of any treatment procedure. So now we will see the articles required for physical examination. So we will need a stethoscope for auscultation purpose, and also to check the blood pressure. And we will need a BP apparatus and thermometer, measuring tape to measure the head circumference, chest circumference and abdominal girt, and also if there is no scintillometer to check the height. Next we will need a tuning fork to see the hearing ability of the patient, and then reflex hammer to see the reflexes, and then nasal speculum to visualize the nose, then tongue depressor to visualize the oral cavity of the patient, then a watch to check the pulse, and then vaginal speculum to do the vaginal examination. And also we will need a Snellen chart. For now I don't have a standard one, so I just made an example of Snellen chart. It will look like this. Maybe many of you have seen when you went for your eye checkup and all. Okay, and also you will need weighing machine to check the weight of the patient, along with the scintillometer where we will check the height of the patient.
So we will explain the procedure to the patient. So we need to provide privacy to the patient. So we need to check the height and the weight of the patient. So next we need to check the general appearance of the patient, where we will check see the body build of the patient. The body build mainly can be classified into three categories: ectomorphic, endomorphic and mesomorphic. So ectomorphic is mainly when the patient is very lean and thin, and then endomorphic is like medium body build, and mesomorphic is when the patient is very obese. So for me, I will categorize her into endomorphic. Next, we will go to vital signs, which include temperature, blood pressure, pulse and respiration. So for this, I will not go into details, because you can go to other video and you can see how it is checked.